Do you want to save energy? Have you seen the latest black boxes on the market that claim to save energy? Here at the Power Systems Experience Center, we see it every day. People are looking for that silver bullet to save money on their power bill, but if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. These black box solutions are often sold under the guise of power quality, claiming to fix a PQ issue like power factor, harmonics, surge, or voltage variations, while also generating energy savings to provide a direct ROI for customers. Here's an example showing the difference.
Transients can destroy electronic components in your home. Surge suppression offers a solution to prevent damage to TVs, DVD players, and stereos. This surge suppressor offers insurance against damaging switching transients caused by the utility, as well as lightning strikes. Would you like to try one on your home?
Compare this technique with the following.
Did you know that every time you type on your keyboard, you create micro transients? These microtransients make the electrons flowing through your system bounce all over the place instead of going in straight lines. This wastes energy. Our transient suppression systems control the flow of the electrons, making them go in straight lines, saving you 8 to 25% of your power bill. Would you like to try one of these systems?
The second method focuses on energy savings, which results in a direct ROI. As ridiculous as the scenario may sound, this method is sometimes used to unsuspecting consumers who may not be knowledgeable on technical aspects of electrical systems. Energy savings is much easier to sell, especially with a payback of 2 years or less. In this video, we will show you some of the techniques used to sell these black box solutions, and while some of them actually do save some energy, as you know, every good lie has a hint of truth, the claims made are often exaggerated. We will try to demystify the energy savings and show you some important considerations you should evaluate before making a purchase.
Sometimes it's not the fault of the person selling the magic box. They have been told a story and they simply repeat what they have heard, accepting the explanation as truth. We have heard many interesting quotes from these passionate salespeople that don't quite follow the laws of electricity. Things like,
these capacitors are different. They aren't regular capacitors like the Eaton ones. These are special capacitors that save energy.
Or, this is patented technology. Only the inventor truly understands this technology. Or,
they don't just work instantly, they work over time.
Or something like this. Utility companies hate our products. They don't like when customers save money on their bills. This couldn't be further from the truth. Utility companies are looking for customers who can reduce their load so they don't have to build more generation capacity. We've even had someone comment,
"You're thinking way too much like an engineer. You may never understand our product."
Sometimes the explanation is so vague that you aren't sure what you're buying.
Our device achieves savings derived from using MOV, TBSS, and line filter capacitance together in one unit, maximizing the energy savings featured in real-time operations, with results that may show up to anywhere from 5 to 20% or more in monthly electrical savings.
We've also heard things like,
"I'm not an electrician, so I can't explain exactly how it works, but we sold some to a company in Alaska and it worked for them."
So how do you know what to believe? Here's the thing, the Electric Power Research Institute said it best. You can only save energy that is wasted. If your electrical system losses are 4%, then you can only save up to 4% by eliminating those losses. The rest of the power you're using is going to useful work. You would need to change the load type or the operation of the load to achieve more savings. In other words, if you used LED lights or variable frequency drives or only turn your lights on half the time, you would actually save energy. But that's not magic, that's just conscientious energy-saving methods that require analysis and hard work.
Why are we so passionate about this topic? It's because vendors selling these solutions as energy savers give the industry a black eye. Surge protectors, capacitors, and harmonic filters work well when they're applied properly and for the purpose they are designed for, but they're certainly not significant energy savers. Some of the claims that would lead you to believe that a black box will save you energy can be categorized as hard savings and soft savings. Hard savings usually focus on energy or demand savings, while soft savings are more obscure and may or may not have a defined payback. Be especially wary of soft savings claims.
This little number not only saves you 25% on your power bill, but will enhance the electrical life of your equipment, improve safety, and protect the environment by reducing emissions from the utility generators.
Sometimes vendors will use confusing numbers. They may obscure the actual savings by comparing losses and load. For example, if the losses on a transformer are 4%, or the transformer is 96% efficient, you could be advised to install a new transformer that's 98% efficient with the claim that you're saving 50% of the losses. But in reality, you would really only save up to 2% of the actual energy bill.
Here at the PSEC, we've seen a lot of variations of these black boxes, but some of the more common ones are either capacitors or capacitors with surge protectors built in. As you may know, everything that we do here at the Experience Center is based on visual learning to teach some of the most complex electrical issues, like harmonics. So we aren't surprised that some of these vendors have also used demo boxes to show how their products work. The problem is that they're only telling you part of the story. So what's in these demo cases? Usually an unloaded motor, a capacitor, a meter, and maybe a few tricks. Let's take a look at how someone might sell you a capacitor for your home as an energy saver.
I always look at it this way. If I could save you at least 1 month's electric bill per year, would you like me? Would you love me? Wouldn't you be happy with savings like that? How it works is complicated, but basically it's a capacitor that stores and regulates electricity. In other words, it makes all your electrical devices in your home operate more efficiently and use less electricity. Let me show you how it works. This is a small motor like you would find in a refrigerator or other appliance. Without our reactive compensator, you would use about 6 amps of electricity from the power company when it runs. Now, watch this. With our device, you use only 3 amps of electricity. That's a 50% savings.
I've only had the reactive compensator in my house for 3 months, and I'm already seeing the savings. My wife looked at our bill from last month, and it was $112. And last year, for the same month, it was $142. That's $30 in savings in 1 month. I'm sold on it. I like it so much that I've told all my friends and workmates about it.
Now let's look at that same demo with more detail in the explanation. Interestingly, this simple meter that's been used to prove the savings by showing the amp reduction can also measure watts. The watts don't change when the capacitor is turned on. The amps and the volt amps, or volts times amps, change dramatically. They're cut in half. The capacitor does nothing, therefore, to the watts, but really only changes the amps in VA. Since we pay for kilowatt hours on our bill won't change. However, it becomes a placebo effect. If you believe you're saving energy, you'll make note of the savings and attribute it to the $600 box that you bought. Then you'll tell all your friends and the story is spread. Since you're more conscious of energy savings after spending $600 on the magic box, you'll likely turn off your lights more often and yell at your kids for leaving the door open when the AC is on. In addition, you may change your lights in your house to LEDs, but may not realize the significant savings you see from the lights because you want to believe it's the magic box. Finally, you will look at your energy bill and compare it to last year, and for the months that you save, you'll attribute it to the box. But for the months that you didn't save, you'll blame yourself or your kids. It's been proven over and over again. Residential data is especially difficult to compare year over year. Year over year savings cannot be used. You have to account for temperature changes and load changes.
So we've proven that you don't save energy or kilowatt hours in your home. What about large motors in commercial and industrial applications? Let's look at another demo now using a 300 horsepower unloaded motor. Here, as we add individual steps of 15 kVAR capacitors, you can see the reduction in the current, or amps, as well as the kVAR and the kVA, with minimal change in kW. Unloaded motors show the most drastic effect for this demo, as they use very little real power, or kW, really just enough to overcome friction, but they require reactive power, or kVAR, to create a magnetic field to allow the motor to spin. If we were to add a mechanical load to the motor, kWs would be required to drive the load. Capacitors act to counteract the kVAR required by the motor, and when both the capacitors and the motor are combined, the only power taken from the utility is the real power, if the capacitance is matched precisely with the kVAR required by the motor. Notice that if you add too much capacitance, you could overcompensate and the current would go back up. Still, even with a larger change in current from about 90 amps down to 15 amps, we aren't saving 80% of the kW. There's less than a 1 kW difference related to the I squared R losses. Since our bill is based on our kilowatt hours in our home and primarily based on the kilowatt hours and the kW demand for our business, we are not saving real power or money off of your bill.
However, saving money and saving energy are not the same thing. Even though they do not save significant power or energy, capacitors can save money in the following ways. Utility penalties, usually in the range of 5 to 30% of the total electrical bill. Capacity improvement, usually the benefit here is that if you install capacitors to improve your kVA capacity, you don't need to buy a new transformer or cables. Finally, I squared R loss reduction can be achieved by installing capacitors near the load to reduce the current. The reality is, however, that power system losses are typically 1 to 4% or less. So as EPRI said, you can only save what you have wasted. So therefore, you can only save up to about 4%. Typical losses on a power system are more like 1% or less. The ROI for a 1% savings is much more than 10 years if you were to install capacitors. This figure shows the actual system losses on a power system and the loss reduction by installing capacitors at the furthest point, at the load. For a total system loss of 76 kilowatts, you can save 11 kilowatts by installing capacitors, saving 15% of the losses, but in reality, only 1.1% of the power bill. Installing them closer to the utility would result in negligible energy savings from I2R losses. Note, however, that to avoid a power factor penalty, they can be anywhere downstream of the utility meter.
For commercial or industrial users, usually the salesperson starts with a suitcase demo, then the conversation goes something like this, what we call the technical sign-off.
Did you see how the current was cut in half? Now, imagine how many motors you have in your facility. I showed you how we could save 50% of the power on that one motor, but I'm not even going to claim that much. Let's agree that we could even save you 15%. It will probably be more like 25%, but even with just 15%, wouldn't you like to share those savings with your boss? I'm going to make you a hero. Don't you want to be a hero? Sign this paper and show that you, the technical person, understand. Then we can present this to your boss and the financial people. They won't understand the technical details, but they will trust you since you saw the savings. When the controller sees that you're going to save him 15% of the energy bill, you will get a big fat raise this year, Mr. Hero.
They may even follow with.
Really, if you're hesitant even after seeing the demo, the savings are guaranteed, so there is absolutely no risk to you. You can get your money back simply by showing that you didn't save the energy that we said you would, up to the amount that you spent with us, of course. So there's really no risk.
Unfortunately, they use hard to prove or disprove guarantees where the burden of proof is on the consumer, and it is extremely costly for a monitoring system to do so.
Here at the Power Systems Experience Center, we've done the calculations, we've done the measurements, we've talked to the vendors, we simply do not believe the excessive claims. Can you save money with power factor correction? Yes, if you're a large utility customer and you have a power factor penalty, but certainly not for a homeowner. Again, it's not that capacitors don't work for their intended purpose of power factor correction, but they're not energy savers.
In addition, putting capacitors in your system without proper analysis and sizing can be problematic, resulting in voltage and harmonic issues.
There are plenty of other examples of vendors exaggerating savings. Many of the details of false energy savings can be found in the technical paper entitled Power Quality Solutions and Energy Savings, What is Real?
Here at the Power Systems Experience Center, we are constantly working to demystify difficult electrical issues by simplifying their explanations through demonstrations. Contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to the Power Systems Experience Center today.